Inside of your mouth, there are usually 32 teeth. 8 incisors, 4 canines, 8 premolars, 8 molars, and 4 third molars. One of these things is not like the other. Hey there, toothers. Trace here for DNews. Thanks for tuning in. The third molars, commonly called wisdom teeth, form as early as age 12, when tissue sacs called follicles migrate to the soft tissues in the back of your jaw and form buds. If they do that, they'll erupt from the gum line by age 25. If you leave those wisdom teeth in place, they can become impacted, they can form cysts, get infected, weaken the bone of the jaw, and this is why, after the advent of anesthesia, dentists began removing them. But not everyone has this same experience. Evolution has completely redrawn the boundaries of the human head, and wisdom teeth got caught in the crossfire. But if there's no room for them, why do we even have them? 100 million years ago, our ancestors' jaws were large enough to make room for all 32 teeth. And they were all useful, with molars doing a lot of grinding and chewing of greens and meats. As we evolved, we really didn't need the big, strong back teeth anymore. After the advent of cooking, food became easier to digest and easier to chew, so again, having a third set of molars was pretty useless. As our ancestral primates took advantage of these evolutionary wins, we also began to walk upright, we grew larger brains, we developed longer arms, and yet somehow, our third molars weren't entirely eliminated. Thanks, Mr. Darwin. That being said, 65% of people don't develop wisdom teeth at all, and some will only get 1, 2, or 3. In one study from the University of Tennessee, Knoxville, African Americans and Inuits tend to have third molar agenesis, meaning that they never develop wisdom teeth buds. In fact, Inuits seem to hardly ever grow wisdom teeth. Alan Mann, an anthropologist from Princeton University, believes that this is because the Inuit tend to have flatter faces and narrower jaws. He believes as the brain got larger, there was no more room in our faces, and the evolutionary advantage went from those who did have those teeth to those who didn't have superfluous, painful teeth. Essentially, their own genetics caused natural selection to weed out the Inuit who grew them, as they likely experienced the medical difficulties associated with those who grow them today and have no way to fix it. On top of that, research from the University of Pennsylvania found a mutation in a gene called MYH16, which resulted in the shrinking of our jaw, further pushing out these stupid teeth. This process actually started hundreds of thousands of years ago. While doing research in China in 2011, Mann, the Princeton anthropologist I mentioned earlier, found the oldest known fossils without wisdom teeth, dating from 300 to 400,000 years ago. Experts think wisdom teeth are similar to pinky toes or human tails. They're vestigial, leftover bits in the ongoing process of evolution. So even though wisdom teeth started out as something useful, today they're more of a pain than a perk. If third molars do appear, and there's not enough space on your jaw for them to fit, the American Association of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgeons recommend that they be removed. Of course, in the end, the fate of this vestigial evolutionary tooth is a matter for you and your dentist to decide. Life is weird, right? What do you guys think of all this? Did you get your wisdom teeth removed? Let us know down in the comments. And while you're out there typing around, make sure you subscribe to Test Tube's newsletter. You can get a weekly roundup of our most popular shows from all across testtube.com. You can find it at testtube.com/forward. And if you're not sick of teeth yet, make sure you check out this video about the disturbing places teeth can grow. It's disturbing. It's in the title.
When he was 18, he began coughing up blood, leading scientists to find a basketball-sized tumor in his chest, which was growing not only teeth, but hair, and what may have been the beginnings of fetal eyes.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Please subscribe. We'll see you next time on DNews.